Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
For those of you visiting, of course, we extend a very warm welcome to you and your families, to our parish and our lady in our Carmel Church. For those of you listening at home, you have your virtual worship aid waiting for you in your email inbox if you are registered to Flocknote. So just be aware that you can follow along on the readings and the hymns. All you need to do is go to your inbox and you will see your virtual worship aid there for you. Today the church celebrates the fifth Sunday of Easter. And I'd like to remind everyone, by the way, that the RSVP list is open for next weekend. And we ask that you call the rectory and submit the first and last name of each of the members in your party. And it's really important that we do that in case we need to do any contact tracing. So we really appreciate your help in that regard. And same, we celebrate the fifth Sunday of Easter this weekend. And Father Alex will lead us in our worship this afternoon. And with that, I pass along to our cantor, Lynn Costello.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome. Today we celebrate how much we need Jesus and each other. And so let us begin by singing the Church's One Foundation. Please stand.
As disciples of the Lord Jesus, we have his life in us. Gathered together in his name, we have faith that he is in our midst, here and now. Let us remain in his love, as his love is the life of us. And receiving his body and blood, let us then be life and love for all the world. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You are greater than our sins and strengthen us to love. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You cause us to grow as branches of the vine to the waters of baptism. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will send down the consoling dew of the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
That in Christ its branch may bring forth to the glory of your name abundant fruits of faith and love. Grant this to our Lord Jesus Christ, the resurrection and the life, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Saul arrived in Jerusalem, he tried to join the disciples, but they were all afraid of him, not believing that he was a disciple. Then Barnabas took charge of him and brought him to the apostles, and he reported to them how he had seen the Lord, and that he had spoken to him, and how in Damascus he had spoken out boldly in the name of Jesus. He moved about freely with them in Jerusalem and spoke out boldly in the name of the Lord. He also spoke and debated with the Hellenists, but they tried to kill him. And when the brothers learned of this, they took him down to Caesarea and sent him on his way to Tarsus. The church throughout all Judea, Galilee, and Samaria was at peace. It was being built up and walked in the fear of the Lord. And with the consolation of the Holy Spirit, it grew in numbers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the first letter of St. John. Children, let us love not in word or speech, but in deed and truth. Now this is how we shall know that we belong to the truth and reassure our hearts before him in whatever our hearts condemn. For God is greater than our hearts and knows everything. Beloved, if our hearts do not condemn us, we have confidence in God and receive from him whatever we ask, because we keep his commandments and do what pleases him. And his commandment is this: we should believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another just as he commanded us. Those who keep his commandments remain in him and he in them. And the way we know that he remains in us is from the Spirit he gave us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said to his disciples, "I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit, and every one that does, he prunes so that it bears more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word that I spoke to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me will be thrown out like a branch and withered. People will gather them and throw them into a fire, and they will be burned. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask whatever you want, and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The story is told about a mother who said, "My married life has been like the mysteries of the rosary. When we were newly married, it was joyful. When my husband's vices came out, it was sorrowful. When he died, it was glorious. And now I'm single again. It is light and luminous." Brothers and sisters, in today's gospel, Jesus tells his disciples remain in me as I remain in you. This is the secret of perseverance and endurance, to remain in God no matter what. Whatever mysteries we go through in life, if we hold on to the Lord, we will continue to live and grow and, yes, bear fruit. It is easy to hold on to the Lord in joyful, glorious, and light moments. But all the more we should hold on to Him on our sorrowful moments. In fact, there is only the Lord to really hold on to at such moments. Instead of letting go of God, we must hold on to Him and not succumb to misery and despair and hopelessness. It is not enough to just exist. We must grow and persist. Yes, we must remain in God and bear fruit. We must not just be living branches. We must be fruit-bearing branches. For those who are still alive and who perhaps are living abundant lives, the question remains, am I living a fruitful life? Have others benefited from my life? My dear friends, in the gospel today, Jesus is talking not only of bearing fruits, but bearing more fruits. And this can be achieved by pruning. My Father is the vine grower, Jesus said. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit, and everyone that does, He prunes, so that it bears more fruit. For those of us who love to do gardening, we know exactly what it means. When a branch does not bear fruit, you have to cut it out, then it bears fruit. That's what happens also in our lives. The unnecessary twigs and leaves have to be cut off from the branch so that the nutrients do not go to waste, but can be channeled directly to the fruit-bearing parts of the plant. This is a painful but necessary process. And this involves a lot of self-denial. This involves a lot of detachment and sacrifices on our part. You know, my dear friends, there are many unnecessary twigs and leaves in our lives, isn't it? And what are these unnecessary twigs and leaves in our lives? This could be our unhealthy vices, like smoking, alcohol, gambling, gossiping, and many others. Or this could be the things we are attached to, but we can do without, like expensive electronic gadgets and many fancy little things that fill our drawers and cabinets. This could also be the fruitless activities which we do, which consume our precious time. Watching garbage television shows, or internet surfing, idle talks, computer games, and the like. And finally, this could also be our unhealthy and sometimes immoral relationships and attachments. Have we ever thought why there are trials, crises, and problems in our lives? Well, perhaps God allows them to happen so that we learn to prune all these unnecessary twigs and leaves, and be able to distinguish the superfluous from the basic essentials in our lives. My dear friends, what are the unnecessary leaves or twigs in your life that need pruning. It is good to examine our lives now and then. What are the unnecessary leaves or twigs in my life that need pruning? If you want to go to heaven, cut all this down, or else you yourself will be cut down and be separated from the vine and thrown into Gehenna. To summarize, there are two main basic things that Jesus wants us to do. First, Jesus wants to tell us that we need to remain united with Him if we want to have life and happiness. For He said, "Apart from me, you can do nothing." The branch must remain united to the vine so that it will bear fruit. Let us look at our lives and see if we are really living a life that is deeply rooted and firmly attached to the Lord. Otherwise, our lives would be empty and meaningless, vain and fruitless and unworthy. Secondly, Jesus wants us to prune the unnecessary twigs in our lives so we can grow and mature and bear fruit. Brothers and sisters, do you want to find real happiness and fulfillment in your life? Then remain in Jesus. Live in Jesus and prune the unnecessary twigs in your life. This is the formula of real joy and happiness. We now profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before ages, God of God, light from light, true God of true God, begotten not made, consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things were made. Cross men for salvation. He came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake was crucified in the Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the Scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. They will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who in the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in the one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Praising God for the wonders of creation, we now bring our prayers to the Lord.
Please respond, source of our life, hear us. For all the baptized, that we may never be separated from Christ, the true vine, Lord, hear us.
Source of our life, hear us.
For the children who just had their first Holy Communion, that they may return to receive the bread of life often. Lord, hear us.
Source of life, hear us.
For those who persecute Christians and treat them badly, that, like St. Paul, they may change their ways. Lord, hear us.
Source of life, hear us.
For a growing respect for the life of every human person reflected in our laws. Lord, hear us.
Source of life, hear us.
For better weather for our farmers, that the crops may be planted special way, and the recently deceased. May they live forever with Christ in the glory of the resurrection. Lord, hear us.
Lord of our life, hear us.
Let us pray in silence for our personal intentions. Lord, hear us.
Source of our life, hear us.
Like to remember today a very dear friend of mine who just had this open heart surgery yesterday for fast healing, Stephen Ende, and for Hector Maroko, who is very, very sick and is at the ICU currently. Lord, hear us.
Source of our life, hear us.
God, our Creator, we praise you for your mighty deeds. Hear the prayers your faithful of people make through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We bring our gifts to the altar, the gifts that are given by God alone. And so we sing, we have been told.
Thank you.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in his sacrifice, have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and St. Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. And safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to our apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you. I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and connect myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
As we approach the altar humbly to taste the sweetness of our Lord Jesus, body and blood, soul and divinity, let us sing together, taste and see.
Let us pray. Lord, remain close to the people you have enriched with these heavenly mysteries, and grant that we may pass from our former ways to new life in the risen Christ. We make our prayer in the name of Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
Kindly be seated for a moment. I am very happy to announce to you that this morning we had our first communion here at Lady Mount Carmel. There were, I think, 14 or 15 kids who had their first communion. They were all smiling with their nice glasses and with their parents. So we are so excited that we had our first communion mass this morning. Last week we had our confirmation mass here for the first time in 4 years. And we had Bishop Manuel Cruz, our main celebrant, last week for our confirmation mass. Brothers and sisters, now that masses have resumed, we ask that you call in the rectory during normal rectory hours and give your name, the mass time, and number of people that will be attending. Any individual who is sick or has flu-like symptoms is urged to stay home. The only sacrifice of the mass can broadcast on several television channels, and the sick can make a spiritual communion until they return to good health. Our Lady Mount Carmel is following the rules and regulations implemented by the CDC and the Archdiocese. Please adhere to the policies while attending Mass. Registration has now begun for the religious education program for the 2021-2022 year. Forms may be downloaded on our website. Once completed, you may drop it off or mail it to the rector. The 2022 Mass book will be opening on Tuesday, May 4th. Masses may be scheduled during office hours. The OLMC's Women's Auxiliary is having a raffle to benefit the parish. Tickets are $50 each with a chance to win $2,500 for first prize. I wish I could win that. You can contact Linda or Maria with any questions you may have. Please check the flyers and its bulletin board of the church for contact and ticket information. We have noticed that there have been many random items left at the Catholic Charities donation bin in our parking lot. Please refrain from leaving anything but clothes, shoes, linens, stuffed animals and things of this nature. Catholic Charities will not take items like furniture or mattresses, and then we are left to dispose of them. Regarding sharing God's blessings and all appeal, this year our parish goal is $27,447.60. Please donate if you can so we can reach our goal this year, just like we did last year. Your generosity is always appreciated. As I've been telling you, week after week, there are many new things going on at OLMC. For those who have come and celebrate with us for the first time after a year or more than a year, you may have noticed many things going on. We have new decorations in church. We have the coin barrel. I always mention about the coin barrel at the entrance of the church. We started that, I think, end of September last year. It's almost filled up now. So if you come to church and you have some spare change, please drop it off at the coin barrel. Thank you always for your generosity. According to the new Archdiocesan guideline, the Feast of the Ascension of the Lord on May 13, Thursday, is transferred to the weekend of May 15 and 16, respectively, Saturday and Sunday. And in lieu of these intentions, which were formerly booked on May 12, at 7 p.m. and May 13 at 7 p.m. are canceled and or transferred to any of the masses on this Ascension weekend. Thank you for your understanding. Let us continue to pray for one another, especially for good health. Let's pray for our country and pray for our world. Please include a special way the people in India. So many are infected with the virus daily. For 5 consecutive days, there were 200 to almost 300,000 people
they shall be for those who have died and also their loved ones. Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your hands and pray for God's blessings. After his blessing, you respond, Amen. May the God who has redeemed you and made you adopted children to the resurrection of his only Son bless you and fill you with joy.
Amen.
May the God who has bestowed on you the gifts of redemption and lasting freedom make you heirs of eternal life.
Amen.
May the God who joined you to Christ's resurrection by faith and baptism lead you to live justly and so bring you to your home in heaven.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended in peace and leave the words of the Gospel.
Thanks be to God.
And now before we leave this holy place, let us sing together one more time. Alleluia, Alleluia, let the holy anthem rise.
I'm not used to taking a pocketbook.